You're back at the ACMIT TV studios here at the 28th ACMIT meeting 2018 in Madrid. My name is Christoph Specht, I'm your host. And this is the Congress of Clinical Microbiology and Infectious Diseases. And obviously, infection control plays a key role. So let's welcome Professor Hilary Humphreys from Ireland. You're from the Royal College of Surgeons in Ireland. And you reviewed all the scientific literature of the infectious control of the last year. Just, if you don't mind, give us an overview of the highlights.
Well, this is a session that occurs every year, and it's often very popular because it's an opportunity for the speaker to provide some highlights to the audience of what has really been happening in the last year. So I focused on two main areas. One was carbapenem-resistant Enterobacteriaceae, or CRE, and Clostridium difficile infection, or CDI, and looked at various aspects of those two main areas, as well as two other papers on central line bloodstream infection and infection in children.
So let's get a little bit more into detail. The last year, as you said, resistance is a big issue, of
Correct.
Course, and the,
yeah.
the rising threat of that, especially you mentioned the CREs. Is there anything particular that which struck you?
One of the things that's emerging in the literature is the differences and the interaction between the acute hospital and units in outside the hospital, particularly in the United States, what are called long-term acute care hospitals, mm-hmm. and then nursing homes and residential units, and the way in which patients move from these and how these resistant organisms can spread, and also how you can use mathematical computational models to predict what interventions might be effective in controlling spread.
So resistance has been all around, not only just in the last couple of years, but if we just make a little time travel, so to speak, in 5 or 10 years, do you think this threat is even bigger than it is now?
It's potentially bigger because in many countries, the number of patients with CRE is increasing, but there are possibilities for us to control it, particularly with aggressive screening patients coming into hospital, isolation and environmental decontamination. And if we don't get that right, many patients may be very problematic to treat because there aren't new antibiotics coming out to treat this group of bacteria.
You just mentioned it, the isolation and screening is yeah. a very important part of it. But this always has to do, at least that's in my experience, with organization in the hospital, on the hospital level, and money, of course, because you need some closures or single rooms, and often you don't find them.
I think there are a lot of pressures that make it a bit more difficult than it might sound obvious. First of all, many hospitals are running close to 100% capacity, so right. there isn't a flexibility. Secondly, there may not be enough single rooms. Mm-hmm. Thirdly, patients may be too close together. And fourthly, there are other priorities, such as getting acutely ill patients into hospital, and various healthcare targets in many countries, which often, if you like, overcome mm-hmm. maybe the priority for infection prevention and control.
So what measures do you think have to be undertaken to tackle this problem?
Well, I think
in the near future.
I think, first of all, we have to have extensive screening to try and pick up these bacteria as soon as patients come into acute hospital in particular. We need to isolate patients that we detect CRE in. We need to then follow up the contacts. So these are patients who are in the same clinical area to make sure, to see whether they have picked it up as well, because they may then be secondary spreaders of CRE. And then other issues like improved hand hygiene, better antibiotic use, and also, importantly, environmental decontamination.
Now, you have been to many ACMIT meetings already. Is there anything special about this 28th ACMIT here in Madrid?
I think there's a bit more emphasis on infection prevention and control in the hospital, which is very welcome, because I think it's an increasing clinical and indeed political priority. And I've been struck by increasing relevance of the use of modern, exciting molecular techniques like whole genome sequencing, being brought from the reference academic environment to, if you like, the hospital, the clinic, where we can use this exciting technology to provide us with answers that previously we weren't able to come up with, and providing us with more detail on patterns of spread of these bacteria.
I'm sure you will be attending the 29th ACMIT then in Amsterdam. Are you looking forward?
Yes, Amsterdam. I've been at ECCMID before in Amsterdam, and it's a good convention center, and it's a great city, and I think there'll be lots of people at it, and I'm sure we'll have even more developments both in infection control and the application of molecular and other techniques to control.
Professor Humphreys, it was nice talking to you. Thank you very much for your time and all the best to you.
You're very welcome. Thank you very much.